Tonight, death at the Olympics.
This is a very sad day. The IOC is in deep mourning.
A young luger is killed in a violent crash at Whistler. Also, against their will.
The suspects were working through an escort agency and forcing these girls to prostitution.
Teenage girls work in a makeshift brothel in Lachine. And a saint of a man. The Vatican prepares to canonize Brother Andre.
CTV News with Mutsumi Takahashi.
Good evening. It happened just hours before the opening ceremonies for the Winter Olympic Games in Vancouver. An athlete was killed on the luge track in Whistler during a practice run. He was a member of the men's luge team from Georgia. And a warning, images of the accident are disturbing. Randy Tieman joins us now. Randy, he lost control at a very, very high speed.
Yeah, absolutely, Mitsumi. He was going at about 150 kilometers an hour, and it was at a part of the track which, of course, the banks are very steep, and it's twisting and it's turning. Now, there have been a number of accidents this past week during the practice runs, but none certainly like this. Nodar Kumar Itashvili was near the end of his run when the accident happened, and he was clocked at just over 144 kilometers an hour. He flew off the sleigh and hit one of the steel poles along the side of the track. He was administered CPR immediately and was taken to the local hospital in Whistler. Now, this track is considered to be one of the most challenging, fastest, and maybe even the most dangerous ever. Olympic champion Armin Zogler of Italy crashed earlier today during one of his practice runs, but then made a clean run. Apparently, a number of the young losers have struggled all week long on this track. A very emotional IOC president, Jacques Rogge, met the media earlier this afternoon.
This is a very sad day. The IOC is in deep mourning. Here you have a young athlete who lost his life in pursuing his passion. He had a dream to participate in the Olympic Games. He trained hard, and he had this fatal accident. I have no words to say what we feel.
Mitsumi, the investigation, of course, is underway now. There's no word if they're going to cancel the event or whether they're going to change the track whatsoever. I think it would be a little bit late for that. But also now there's some question as to whether the Georgian team will participate in the Olympics. All this, of course, still in doubt. The investigation underway, but that's all that the IOC had to say.
Okay. Thank you very much, Randy.
Thank you.
The accident cast a shadow over what was otherwise a day of celebrations. After a coast-to-coast journey, the torch relay was nearing its end. Anticipation is building for tonight's opening ceremonies. Tom Kennedy reports.
Long before the sun came up, the flame was out and so were people. The last day of the longest torch relay in Olympic history. Worth watching. Among the final runners, some unfamiliar faces, others that would be recognized almost anywhere in the world. Among them, California governor and movie star Arnold Schwarzenegger. These are the final hours now of a journey that began far, far away. October 22nd at the ancient site of Olympia in Greece. A ceremony nearly 3,000 years old, the flame lit with the rays of the sun that makes its way to the site of the great athletic contest. To get there, a 2,200-kilometer relay through Greece, then on to Canada, a 45,000-kilometer relay, bringing this symbol to places that never would have imagined it. And now Vancouver, to get this far, 12,000 torchbearers. Among them, in these last moments, a 92-year-old man, legendary Vancouver musician Dal Richards, and a couple of fathers of the famous, Raleigh Fox, father of the late Terry, and Walter Gretzky. An ancient tradition in modern times. And just as what happened 3,000 years ago, the site is ready. The athletes have arrived. Shortly too, so will the flame. The games are about to begin. Tom Kennedy, CTV News, Vancouver.
Tom Kennedy joins us now from Vancouver. You know, Tom, I've been watching coverage of that torch relay all day. It looks pretty exciting now. I know that as a journalist, you're expected to be objective about all this, but do you find yourself getting a little caught up in this as well?
It's hard to avoid, Mutsumi. I mean, especially for me in a sense, because I was in Greece on the 22nd of October when this flame was lit in that extraordinary backdrop, the ancient site of Olympia, where the Olympic Games first began more than 3,000 years ago. So I did not follow the flame across Canada, but I saw it leave Greece and come to Canada. I've read all about this longest domestic relay in Olympic history, the 45,000 kilometer relay through Canada. So when you see the images of where this flame has been and you understand how far it has gone and you see the effort the organization here in Vancouver made to really involve as much of Canada as possible, and now you see the flame in the last hours. I don't want to sound too too melodramatic here, but it is difficult not to get up in some kind of excitement and anticipation about what's going to happen in the city and in the country over the next couple of weeks.
And you know, Tom, watching you there in Vancouver, you know, I know you've been working from out of the country at the London Bureau for so long. It's got to be interesting for you to come back here for the Olympics and really see Canadians at their best.
Yes, and you're also seeing one of the most beautiful cities in the country here in Vancouver. Unfortunately for the organization, one of the warmest Januaries in history. So there are a lot of reasons to be very happy about being here and very happy to be seeing this particular event. The Olympics, I think this will be my fifth or my sixth games I think I've covered, but it is actually the first winter games I've covered. And because we are a northern country, we're much more adept at winning in winter sports. And we are very close to winter sports. So in that sense as well, it's going to be very exciting after having lived in Europe 10 years to be here and to see some hockey and to see some skiing and the kind of winter sports that we in Canada enjoy to watch so much.
But you know, despite all this, unfortunately, we can't get away from the fact that an athlete was killed this afternoon. It's got to be awfully difficult for all the other athletes there. Will there be anything done tonight, do you know, during the opening ceremonies in commemoration?
Well, anything to do with the opening ceremonies is a very closely guarded secret. It's certainly quite possible. I also think it's certainly quite possible that there will be some changes made to the track up there at Whistler before the actual competition begins tomorrow. Some of the experts are saying that they're going to have to do something about that area, that corner. That corner, which is the final corner in the run down that hill, was never considered to be particularly dangerous, but they're talking now they will have to build it up, make it 3 or 4 feet higher so that in case of accidents people will stay on the track instead of flying off. This has cast a long shadow over these Olympic Games. These Olympic Games are going to go ahead anyway, but I have no doubt that during the Games reference is going to be made, and we will see every now and then we'll see signs of this tragic, horrific accident that has happened just hours before these Games actually begin.
Yeah, because that athletic community is such a tight community. They must be feeling it so hard. Okay, well, thank you so much for joining us today, Tom.
It's my pleasure. Bye-bye.
And students from St. Edmund's Elementary School in Beaconsfield say they've arrived at the 2010 Olympics. Since September, they've been walking around the schoolyard, equaling the kilometers it would have taken to get to Vancouver. And today they're opening ceremonies. The story from Tara Schwartz.
From little hands come the spirit of the Olympic Games.
As soon as they said, "J'imagine," we turned the circles. We were doing the Olympic circles.
Children are very excited, even though they are in kindergarten, they know lots about the Olympics.
From native drums to ringing bells, in these children's imaginations, they've made it all the way west.
We've been walking to Vancouver.
Since the beginning of the year.
It's pretty cool.
With each toque, with each talk, with each bright red symbol, opening ceremonies at St. Edmund's officially begins.
The Olympics come in and every teacher talks about it. Every teacher does it in class. And we go over the Inukshuk. We go over the why do we have rings, five rings, and why do we have five different colors.
They express themselves through dance, through their love of sport.
I like hockey. I play it myself. And skating, fast skating, skiing. That's pretty cool.
I like about the sports. When I grow up, I think I want to be an Olympic girl.
An Olympic girl who knows she can dream big.
Well, they understand that they're special, that they're held in Canada, our country, And if they have a dream, they could pursue it. We have been telling them that, so that's wonderful.
I want it to be extra special for the kids, and since I am the phys ed teacher, I want it to be as active as possible.
The flame is lit, and the crowd goes wild.
That's because they're coming to Canada.
Go Canada! Canada all the way, man. Canada all the way.
Those little hands again, urging Canada to go for gold. Tyler Schwartz, CTV News.
Expectations are running high for Canada at the Olympics. On Talkback Montreal today, we'd like to know, will Canada surpass its last Olympic medal total of 24? You can let us know by calling 514-790-1212, or you can go to our website, ctvmontreal.ca. We'll have the results a little later on in the newscast. Felt a little colder today than...
It was a little chillier here in Montreal this afternoon, a little cooler than it has been the past couple of days anyway. Here's a look at what's happening right now on our latest satellite picture. We've got a low spinning out over the Atlantic. It is pushing some cloud our way. So we saw some sun in the morning and then an increase in cloud this afternoon. Today's high in Montreal, -7 with a wind chill this afternoon of -15. Winds today from the west at 20 kilometers per hour. Our record high in the state, 9.1. That was set in 1999. The record low, -30.6. And that was set in 1967. Thankfully, we're nowhere near that. A very bearable day here in Montreal when you consider it is the month of February here in the city. It looks like we will see some clouds, a few flurries around for the weekend. All the details coming up a little later.
Thanks, Lori. The founder of St. Joseph's Oratory is headed for sainthood. Vatican Radio says Brother André will soon be canonized. The official announcement is expected next Friday. André Bessette was a Holy Cross brother who's credited with performing miracles and healing the sick. He died in 1937 at the age of 91. A 38-year-old St. Lambert man will have to undergo a psychiatric evaluation after he was arrested and charged with the murder of his father. His lawyer says the man has battled schizophrenia for the past 10 years. Stéphane Gihou has the story.
38-year-old Bjorn Emeriat appeared in Longueuil Court, where he was charged with killing his father, 61-year-old Bernard Emeriat, a philosophy professor at Cégep Édouard Maupetit. His mother was sitting on the front row with friends and relatives.
Okay. There's one charge, second-degree murder.
Bjorn Emeriat had recently moved back with his parents on Merton Street in St. Lambert. He suffers from schizophrenia and was seen every 2 weeks at the Montreal General Hospital. Witnesses say the man was taking his medication, but yesterday he displayed some awkward behavior during the afternoon, though nothing that prepared the family for what was about to happen.
At a moment, a voice in his head said to him, "Kill your father," and he followed that voice.
His mother was on the second floor and had to be treated for shock. The son didn't resist when police arrived.
The son opened the door and he said to the officers, "I just did something maybe bad to my dad. Don't look around, I am the suspect," so they arrest him on the scene.
The court immediately agreed to have Bjorn Emeriat sent for a psychiatric evaluation.
We have to have a psychiatric evaluation on his criminal mind at the moment of the crime.
There were apparently no warning signs.
He's never been aggressive in the past with his family or with his friend.
The man's fate will now rest in the hands of psychiatrists to determine if he's fit to stand trial. Stéphane Giroux, CTV News in Longueuil.
A 49-year-old NDG man faces charges in connection with running a juvenile prostitution ring. Philip Lafferty surrendered to police yesterday. Two other men have also been charged. Rob Lurie reports.
Philip Lafferty lives in this duplex in NDG. Neighbors say they saw him coming and going late at night, but are shocked to learn Lafferty has been charged with running a juvenile prostitution ring. He and two other men allegedly lured two 17-year-old girls from New Brunswick to work at a makeshift brothel in Lachine.
The suspects were working through an escort agency and forcing these girls to prostitution.
Lafferty turned himself into police earlier this week. Also charged are 23-year-old Austin Wilson
and 36-year-old Miles Tynes.
It's surprising that those things happen in our neighborhood, says this Lachine resident.
Very big problem in Montreal.
Aki Chitakoff works with street kids. He says desperate young people are easy targets.
They're really easy prey for unscrupulous and some very sophisticated, organized criminals. They would do anything for a good warm meal, to have a place where they can spend the night, they have some decent clothes, a little bit of money. So they're very, very easy targets.
Lafferty is now behind bars. He'll have a bail hearing next Thursday. Rob Lurie, CTV News.
And coming up, remembering a maverick. Former Tory MP Hewitt Grafty dies at the age of 81. Barry Wilson will be by with his look back at the weekend news. And in entertainment, Montrealers are getting into the Olympic spirit.
Tomorrow, who will become the first Canadian to win gold on home soil? First time, men's downhill, with Whistler's own Manuel Osborne Parody, going for gold on his home course. Then, get ready for ladies' moguls, Jen Heim, defending her Olympic title. Later, it's men's 1500-meter short track speed skating, Charles Hamelin, the current 500-meter world champion. For one of these Canadians, history awaits tomorrow on CTV.
At New Look Eyewear, when we say it's free, we mean it's really free.
To celebrate their 25th anniversary, New Look Eyewear is giving you the frames.
Yes, free frames.
Seeing is believing.
August 5th, Bell Center. The event. Michael Bublé is coming home. Let me go home. In a spectacular new show. With special guest, Naturally 7. Tickets are on sale now by calling 790-2525 or order online at geg.ca. Michael Bublé, presented by Gillette Entertainment Group and Live Nation.
When I was a kid, I wanted to be a superhero. You know, handsome, bulging muscles, saving people's lives at the last minute. Well, now, I just save lives.
You as long as I can.
Channing Tatum, Amanda Seyfried.
I miss you so much it hurts.
Dear John.
Now playing.
For 25 years, New Look has continued to break new ground.
And thanks to New Look's digital lab, you get custom precision engineered HD lenses.
Easy to adapt to with unparalleled vision clarity.
All at a direct from manufacturer price.
Say uh-huh.
Closed captioning of the CTV program is brought to you by Biron, where your health doesn't wait.
Critics are demanding an explanation. The Shahid government's latest plan for a handful of illegal Jewish private schools is raising a lot of eyebrows. The critics also say the government is going too far to accommodate a religious minority. Annie DeMelt reports.
This is one of a handful of private Jewish schools at the heart of what's turning out to be a communications nightmare.
Well, private schools need to be legal.
So the government has been struggling with the problem for years. What to do about a few ultra-Orthodox Jewish schools that concentrate on religious studies and don't devote enough time to Quebec's curriculum. The latest attempt to get them on board, change the school calendar so they can teach on Sundays, meet the ministry standards, and hold on to its funding.
Well, for our community, this is a no-brainer.
Good news for the Quebec Jewish Congress, but the opposition and some teachers' unions say the Charest Liberals are bending over backwards to accommodate a religious minority, calling it a step backwards for the secular school system.
If they're trying to drive some kind of a secular society agenda, then maybe they should take a look at the crucifix in the National Assembly, you know, rather than pick on a bunch of kids, you know, in Outremont who are trying to conform with the law.
Beyond reasonable accommodation, the Montreal Teachers Association worries this will open the door for all schools to open on weekends.
I already have teachers from my adult ed sector and my vocational education sector worrying that they're going to be called upon to work on the weekends. And I don't think that the minister's comments were clear. I don't think her intent was clear when she finally said, this is what it's really about. Well, if that's what it's really about, say what you mean what you say, stand up for it.
The teachers' unions are massively rejecting Quebec's plans which are still subject to change. Annie DeMalt, CTV News.
There was a ceremony today for a new university campus on the South Shore. The new Longueuil campus of the University of Sherbrooke officially opened this morning. The 16-floor building cost $125 million. The school offers a variety of degree courses in Longueuil, many of them adapted specifically for the workforce. The university will hold an open house tomorrow for the public. Maverick former Progressive Conservative MP Heward Grafty has died at the age of 81. Grafty was being cared for at the Royal Victoria Hospital after he was reportedly assaulted at his home last month. He was first elected as MP for the Brome-Missisquoi riding in 1958. He continued to represent the riding off and on for 18 years. He briefly served as a minister in Joe Clark's cabinet. Grafty is survived by three children. And now here's Postscript, CTV News executive producer Barry Wilson with his take on some of the news this week.
I think the producers of that show Prison Break should come to Quebec. This is the place to get your get-out-of-jail cards, and you don't even have to ask for them. The bright lights in our public security department admitted this week that last year, 34, yes, 34 prisoners in Quebec jails were released by mistake. Administrative errors, you see. How do you release a prisoner by mistake? It's not as if we don't have enough bureaucrats in Quebec. Always seems to be enough revenue people to pick your pockets for every last dime. How on earth do you screw up so badly? To make it worse, among those released, a pedophile and a spouse abuser. The minister says it's an outrage. Well, you think? I hope the people responsible for this will get more than a slap on the wrist. Somehow, I think this is just the tip of the iceberg. It was a stunning announcement this week, and the shockwaves are still being felt. The commander of Canada's largest military base, a decorated colonel charged with murder and sexual assault. Crime so heinous, so troubling and chilling. Colonel Russell Williams, though, like everyone, will have his day in court, although he will have a tough time now finding an impartial jury. In the aftermath, it's our military that may take a hit, and that's too bad. It has done so much to rehabilitate itself after embarrassments such as Somalia and even Rwanda. Our top general says it is time for our soldiers to wear the uniform proudly. I agree. Canadians are proud of our soldiers for their sacrifice. The alleged crimes of one man, no matter how high ranking, should not be a reflection of the entire military. And if it turns out that anything was ever covered up or overlooked, then, only then, can we make a judgment. For now, we must give the benefit of the doubt, and to all of our soldiers, our continued respect. Finally, to something a lot brighter. The Olympics are about to get underway, and it will be quite a show. I have no doubt that all Canadians will be proud of Vancouver 2010. Canada has put a lot of effort into doing well here. There will be proud moments for us all to see when we have our young men and women on the podium, and I expect the efforts will pay off. But as they say, winning isn't everything. Our pride should also come from showing the world who we are, what as a country we can accomplish. Enjoy the ride. I'm Barry Wilson, and that is CTV Postscript for this week. See you after the Olympics.
And Postscript can also be heard every Saturday morning on CJD 800 right after the 7:30 news. If you can't make it out to the Vancouver Olympics, you can still share in the excitement. A lot of sports bars in town will be showing Olympic events. And if you want to watch on a really big screen, you can even head to a movie theater. Nadine Ishak joins us now from the Nova Scotia Bank Theater downtown. And Nadine, this is the first time you can watch Olympics in a cinema, I guess.
This is going to be a totally different Olympic watching experience, Mitz. HD, surround sound, and as you said, huge screens. And they're showing some pretty big events. They're showing both the gold medal games for women's and men's hockey, figure skating, and of course the opening and closing ceremonies. You can get a full day pass for $10, and $30 will get you an unlimited passport for the entire Olympics. And you can get all the details at cineplex.com. So tonight kicks off the event for athletes and fans, and it's also brought a golden opportunity for Montrealer Nikki Yanofsky. Behind I Believe, that's the theme song of CTV's Olympic broadcast. It premiered last week at the Super Bowl, and it's already hit number one on iTunes Canada. Now Nikki just turned 16, and she's made all kinds of headlines already with performances at the Jazz Fest, but this, she says, is a unique opportunity and with an inspiring song.
I think it's such a good, well-written song, and the words are so, like I said, so relatable. And when I was singing it, not only was I thinking about the Olympics, but I was also thinking about like what I have to do to become, to go where I want to go, you know, like in singing and music.
Nikki's in Vancouver, and she'll perform tomorrow at the inaugural broadcast of Olympic Morning on CTV. Puccini's Tosca was the very first performance put on by Opéra de Montréal in 1980, and now they're bringing it back to mark their 30th anniversary. Tomorrow's your last chance to catch this performance, and it features an interesting twist. It will have a performance from Annie Sanssouci. She's the winner of Apéro à l'Opéra. That's a competition that was put out to non-professional singers, and she'll be performing the most famous aria from Tosca at tomorrow's 2 p.m. show at Place des Arts, and there are still tickets available for that. And legendary guitarists Eric Clapton and Jeff Beck will be performing at the Bell Centre on Monday, February 22nd. They've shared the stage in Japan, London, and now they're touring North America. We're giving away free tickets to this show, and you might even catch a preview of Jeff Beck's new album dropping in April. For your chance to win two tickets, just call CTV's interactive phone line, 514-790-1212. Good luck.
Thank you very much, Nadine. Now, there could be some flurries in the area overnight. Lori joins us after the break. And later, just in time for Valentine's Day, there's a whole lot of loving going on at the Montreal Children's Hospital.
Hey, hey, mama said the way you move gonna make you sweat, gonna make you groove.
The evolution of rock. The spirit of rock shown. 97.7.
You want a new bathroom, but you don't want to spend $1 million. You want the snazzy look of a renovation, but you don't want to renovate. You want to know when the job's going to start and when it's going to finish. You must be really difficult. Well, actually, you're just like the hundreds of thousands of people who've turned to Bathfitter for their dream bathroom. It costs way less than renovating. There's no messy demolition. And you don't have three guys named Daryl in your house for a month. You're not really difficult. You're just really smart.
Bathfitter. It's a renovation without the renovating. 1-866-997-2284.
Ever since I turned 18, I have a bunch of privileges I didn't have before. I can vote, go to bars, and give blood. For someone who always dreamed of saving the world, it's a good start.
Sighty, sexy, sensual. That's me. I'm looking for hot experiences. Come admire the moonlight from my balcony. Intrigued? I'm waiting for you. See you at BonnevilleHomes.com.
For a limited time, get up to $10,000 in upgrades from Bonneville. Order your Bonneville home today and take advantage of an offer that is simply breathtaking.
Find your soulmate at BonnevilleHomes.com.
Rossman gets a ribbon! It's with 53!
Yeah?
Insane! Insane!
Didn't you totally call it?
Yeah. Okay, gotta go.
It was a laser to the top corner. Hockey history was made tonight. All with less than a minute to go. 1 minute. What a goal!
This year, invest in your health. 30 minutes of exercise three times a week makes a big difference. So take advantage. Right now, all of our exercise equipment is reduced up to 50% off. Plus, we pay both taxes. Only at Club Sin Super Fitness.
The evolution of rock. The spirit of rock shown 97.7.
People getting into the Olympic spirit.
Yeah, don't want to say anything, but take a look at this.
People, not a coincidence.
People are wearing their Olympic red in support of our Canadian athletes. So let's go to Weather Picks, which has now been turned into Olympic Picks. We're asking you to show us your Olympic spirit. And this photo was sent to us from Diane and Pierre Lessard. They just got their Olympic mittens, so they said they're all ready for the games. They took this picture on a small lake in Grenville-sur-la-Rouge. Sylvain sent us a shot of the Olympic rings here in Montreal, a little reminder of the 76 Montreal Games. And Olympic spirit is alive and well all the way down in Venezuela. So we encourage you to send us your Olympic photos here at weatherpicks@ctv.ca. If you're throwing any big, crazy Olympic parties, we would like to see the photos, the evidence, whatever you want to call it, send it right here. Here's a look at what's happening right now on our latest national satellite picture. Heavy snow continues for the southeastern United States. Places like Louisiana, Mississippi, Alabama, the Virginias, the Carolinas, they're all seeing snow. But again, the one place that really needs the snow, west coast of Canada, not really seeing much. And we'll have your Olympic forecast coming up a little later. Meantime, we have that low that continues to spin out over Newfoundland. It is sending a little bit of cloud our way, and that'll be the trend as we head into the weekend. So we're looking at some instability through the weekend. It'll send mainly cloudy skies our way. There is a possibility of seeing a few flurries here and there, but really not a lot of moisture associated with this system. So any precipitation we do get will be very light. We're calling for no more than 1 or 2 centimeters of accumulation. Here's a look at our forecast for tonight. We're calling for mainly cloudy skies, yes, a 40% chance of flurries overnight with a low of -8. Tomorrow, still that 40% chance of flurries in the morning. The probability of precipitation will drop to about 30% in the afternoon, but the winds will pick up out of the west at 20 kilometers an hour. Temperatures slightly above normal at -3 degrees. Comfortable temperatures, once again, the rule for Saturday, with daytime highs anywhere from -3 to -7 in Sherbrooke. Here's a look at the 5-day forecast for Montreal. It is going to be mainly gray this weekend, so don't forget to do something to brighten your Valentine's Day. Yes, it's coming up on Sunday. We could see a few snow showers. In fact, Sunday looks like the best day for snow showers, but very light accumulations again, and it looks like the instability will continue into early next week. We're not expecting to see very much sunshine all week next week here in Montreal, but temperatures will remain mild, will remain above normal. Right now, we're sitting at -8 Celsius, the wind chill -16. Mitsumi, back to you.
Thanks, Lori. And now here's Guy Thibodeau with a look at the alpine ski conditions.
Well, Mitts, not much new snow to report anywhere this week except for the eastern townships and New England. So ski areas are having to deal with what they have and what they've made. That means machine-made snow runs are all well covered, but natural runs and glades are thin and not very skiable. Luckily, all main runs at most centers have machine-made snow. Skiing early this weekend especially will be key to getting to the best snow. Centers in the mountains of the eastern townships and New England, particularly along the border, picked up 20 to 24 centimeters of snow early in the week, while Beaumont and Montjoie only received about 4. It's whiter and more wintry here. The snow as you approach ski resorts is also not as worn out and used. Quebec and Charlevoix centers will be like elsewhere north of the St. Lawrence this weekend on hard-packed surfaces, worth skiing early for the best snow. I'm Guy Thibodeau with the CTV Snow Report.
And coming up in On Your Side Consumer News, a few simple things you can do to make winter driving safer.
Hi, this is Randy Tieman. San Francisco's Tim Lincecum gets a raise only a baseball player could get. All the details coming up on CTV Sports.
I think they will. I think they'll do a lot better than the last Olympics.
Why do you say that?
I think there's a lot of hype in Canada for especially being in Vancouver and all. So I think they'll do a lot better.
They should. They're definitely gonna win hockey. Yeah.
They're definitely gonna win hockey. Yeah.
I'm from Philly, and I'll tell you, they're going to win hockey.
I don't want to jinx anything.
You don't want to jinx anything. But in your heart, what do you think?
Like, in my heart, I hope they do.
Tonight, more than 80 nations will come together in the spirit of competition and a celebration of excellence. As five-time Olympic medalist Clara Hughes carries the flag for Canada. Come together to witness the spectacle and show the world that you believe. The opening ceremony of the Vancouver 2010 Olympic Winter Games, tonight on CTV.
Famous for its succulent seafood, Le Phare du Nord offers you a variety of charcoal-grilled fresh fish prepared using our chef's secret recipe. Whether you come with family or friends, you're sure to receive the same courteous service. Le Phare du Nord is the ideal place for business meals or celebrating birthdays and other special occasions. Le Phare du Nord has a delicious mixed grill and delectable fresh lobster. For reservations, 450-688-9999.
You want a new bathroom, but you don't want to spend $1 million. You want the snazzy look of a renovation, but you don't want to renovate. You want to know when the job's going to start and when it's going to finish. You must be really difficult. Well, actually, you're just like the hundreds of thousands of people who've turned to Bathfitter for their dream bathroom. It costs way less than renovating. There's no messy demolition. And you don't have three guys named Daryl in your house for a month. You're not really difficult. You're just really smart.
Bathfitter, it's a renovation without the renovating. 1-866-997-2284.
When IKEA thinks about designing a closet, we think about organization. That's why 73 of Anne's shoes did not just topple on Trevor, not making him utter a rather shocking profanity that can't be repeated on television, and not prompting Anne to reply, "Well, you're pathetic, Trevor, and you have tiny feet." Shoe addictions. We thought of that.
Save 20% on all PAX wardrobe systems. IKEA. Any space can be beautiful.
Say,
Closed captioning of the CTV program is brought to you by Biron, where your health doesn't wait. You're watching CTV News with Mutsumi Takahashi.
U.S. Marines and Afghan troops have launched an attack on Marja in Helmand province. It's believed to be the last and the biggest Taliban stronghold in Afghanistan. Thousands of American Afghan troops have surrounded the town for weeks. They finally got the order to launch an assault on the Taliban. It is the largest military offensive of the nine-year-old war. Civilians are being told to stay indoors, but many of them are just leaving the town. Humanitarian organizations are preparing for as many as 40,000 refugees. And today marks 1 month since the magnitude 7 earthquake hit Haiti. A remembrance ceremony was held today near Haiti's presidential palace. It was heavily damaged by the earthquake. At least 217,000 people have died in that earthquake. About 300,000 people are injured, 1 million homeless. Another prayer service was held across the country during the National Day of Mourning. Been a lot of snow for us so far this winter. Still, with the cool temperatures and the potential for black ice, driving conditions can get tricky. In this week's On Your Side Consumer Report, Tanya Kriviak has some common sense reminders.
Okay, so we haven't had to deal with a lot of snow so far this winter. The last storm was back in December. Still, that doesn't mean winter driving conditions don't apply. Case in point, when driving instructor Tony Vlahakis took us out on the road for a crash course, it was bone dry.
It's the kind of day where conditions on the road seem like they're pretty good. Yet, if we had to come to a quick stop, there's no doubt that we would skid a little bit because the roads are kind of solid right now because it's been cold the last little while and our tires don't have the same adhesion when it's that cold.
Bottom line, keep a safe distance.
Right now, we're approximately 2 seconds behind this vehicle.
And reduce your speed.
Remember, the posted speed limits are for ideal conditions. So when we see the 50 kilometers an hour, that is for ideal conditions.
Of course, focus on the road.
Your eyes and your hands are the two important factors there. Look straight down the road and steer towards the...
And if a car in front of you is having trouble...
First reaction is come off the gas, start braking, take a look around, see is there room for you to escape. If you've kept that proper following distance, you should have room either to stop or to actually move around the obstruction in front of you.
If you're the one skidding,
release the brake, return back to center. Your eyes should be looking where you want to go. If you see his car has skid a little bit too much, remember, don't follow the nose of the car. Steer in the direction you want your vehicle to go.
Just a couple of reminders for safe winter on the roads, snow or no snow. For the On Your Side Consumer Report, I'm Tanya Kriviak.
And the Canadians are already playing.
Canadians are underway, and I brought the pizza. I brought the pizza. It's just a small one. It's just a small pizza, but I thought the game is already underway. We'll update the score between the Canadians and Philadelphia, 6 o'clock start. We've got that and a whole lot more when we come back.
For 25 years, New Look has continued to break new ground.
And thanks to New Look's digital lab, you get custom precision engineered HD lenses.
Easy to adapt to with unparalleled vision clarity.
All at a direct from manufacturer price.
When your bathroom was built, your boyfriends wore bell bottoms. And since then, mildew's moved in like your mother-in-law, Sheila. You need Bath Fitter. Bath Fitter cleans and repairs all surfaces before they install their tubs and walls. And because their products are seamless, you get an air and watertight seal. So you can say goodbye, mildew. Hello, beautiful new bathroom. All at a fraction of the cost of renovating. Plus, there's a lifetime guarantee, so it'll be around forever. Like Sheila.
Bath Fitter. It's a renovation without the renovating. 1-866-997-2284.
Hello, ma'am.
I'd like a package that includes basic illico.
Okay.
Telephone service with voicemail.
Mm-hmm.
And for internet, you know, those online games where people get blown to bits. Widget downloads, streaming, social networks, Twitter, all that sort of thing.
Yeah.
Well, I don't want any of that. Just my trusty email.
No problem. We have several connection speeds to choose from.
Toyota says they have the most fuel-efficient passenger car lineup in Canada. In four direct comparisons, Chevrolet gets the best highway fuel efficiency. Chevrolet Malibu, Cobalt, Silverado, and all-new Equinox. Compare them to anyone, and may the best car win.
At New Look Eyewear, when we say it's free, we mean it's really free.
To celebrate their 25th anniversary, New Look Eyewear is giving you the frames.
Yes, free frames.
Seeing is believing.
I'm thinking is I got to get to that thing before it gets cold.
Yeah, it's good. We got to get over this real quick. First of two games, of course, against the Flyers. This one in Philadelphia. Game two goes tomorrow night at the Bell Center. And then the Olympic break. Carey Price with the starting goal for the Canadiens. Both P.K. Subban and newcomer Dominic Moore are playing in the game. They're first with the Canadiens. Subban is replacing Andrei Markov. The Canadiens with the first real good chance on the turnover in this hockey game. Plekanec with the shot. Layton with the glove save. Now, Moore is wearing number 42. He's on a line with Metropolitan and Moen. Subban is playing with Gill. Price caught a break early in this one. The shot deflected, went off the crossbar to keep this one scoreless. And then shortly after that, the big save on Hartnell in close, but the Flyers have scored in this hockey game. It is now 1-0 Philly in the first period. And there you have it. The NHL's trade freeze was this afternoon. At 3 p.m., the Ottawa Senators signed general manager Brian Murray to a contract extension. He then picked up Matt Cullen from Carolina for Alex Picard and a second-round draft choice. Now, the biggest deal of the day involved Minnesota and Chicago. The Hawks sent defenseman Cam Barker to the Wild for Kim Johnsson and a 2009 first-round pick in Nick Leddy. Johnsson is a UFA at the end of the year. Leddy is still in university. Now, the Hawks had to clear out some money, and they did. Barker is in the first year of a three-year deal worth $9.25 million. Well, if you missed it off the top of the newscast, tragedy prior to the opening of the games in Vancouver tonight, earlier this afternoon, a 21-year-old Georgian luger, Nodar Kumar Istashvili, died after crashing during a practice run. There have been a number of accidents this past week during the practice runs, but none certainly like this. He was near the end of his run when the accident happened. He was clocked at just over 144 kilometers an hour. He flew off the sleigh and hit one of the steel poles alongside the track. He was administered CPR immediately and taken to a hospital in Whistler. Now, the track is considered one of the most challenging and the fastest and maybe even the most dangerous ever. Olympic champion Armin Zogler of Italy crashed earlier today but then made a clean run. Apparently, a number of the young losers have struggled all week long. A very emotional, of course, IOC President Jacques Rogge met the media and said they are very saddened by this news. Baseball news, Frank Thomas says that he's finally at peace himself. He called it quits after 19 years in the bigs this afternoon. The 41-year-old hit 521 home runs and was the American League MVP twice. San Francisco Giants have avoided arbitration with two-time National League Cy Young Award winner Tim Lincecum. It's a two-year deal worth $23 million with a $2 million signing bonus. He made under $1 million last year. He's 40-17 in three big league seasons. Well, it's world record day here on CTV Sports. It started in Dubuque Luther College in Dubuque, Iowa last night. Dennis Dieters got a shot at the Guinness World Record for the number of half-court shots made in 1 minute. He made two on the first attempt, took a break, and then hit three on the second attempt, and only one on the third attempt. And he was done like dinner. The record, by the way, is six. And check this out. At the University of Alberta in Edmonton, 1,200 people, 600 balls, and a new dodgeball world record. Now, can you imagine being in the middle of this? And imagine being the last guy on one side. I have to say, though, it does look like it was a whole lot of fun. CTV Sports Nights are back. If your team wants to take us on, and we've got a heck of a team, all you need is a team of 12, an ice rink, and a recognized Montreal charity or community organization for raising some money for. You can visit ctvmontreal.ca for all the details. Like I said, we're real good. And, of course, it's Friday, which means it's time for our Plays of the Week.
Made a great sound. Seemed to really work the club on the way through the ball.
So the Avalanche have accomplished that much in this game. Now there's one more important point to play for. Kaminsky in seconds. Raptors.
Over the line, crisscrosses to Wheeler with speed, back to Ryder, that's a beautiful goal!
Last year, watch that form.
Hey, I guess he's seven for seven. For Briere, in the circle, shot, save Brodeur, rebound, and somehow Marty Brodeur made it.
Picked up, look out. Gets past Manning, and it's Tracy Porter.
Still 1-0 Philadelphia.
Was that a great game?
It was a great game.
Thanks, Randy.
Okay.
And now some highlights of the final day of the Olympic flame relay.
Sports Relay Today, brought to you by Coca-Cola. Open the games. Open happiness. That's my 2%.
Rossman gets a rebound and scores with 50.
Yeah?
Insane. Insane. Didn't you totally call it?
Yeah. Okay, gotta go.
Less than a minute to go. 1 minute. What a goal!
So what if it's getting cold and everyone's inside? My heart is warm as a fire when I'm by your side. The best things in life are always a simple thing.
Walmart. Unbeatable prices on everything for Canadian families. Walmart. Save money. Live better.
That's my 2%.
Northeastern United States got hit with snow earlier in the week. Later on in the week, well, the turn for southeastern United States to get a little bit of snow. They even had snow in Texas. We got a weather pick about it, but the rain continues for British Columbia. Here's a look at our Olympic forecast. It's going to be very rainy coming up tomorrow. Cypress Mountain expecting to see 20 to 30 millimeters and some fog, which could be problematic. A couple of centimeters of snow expected at Whistler, but that'll be followed up by 5 to 10 millimeters of rain. Here's a close-up of our area. Well, we've got that upper level low, and there's not going to be much change in our forecast here either. We're expecting to see mainly cloudy skies, but snow showers right through the weekend and through next week. Very little in the way of sunshine, but temperatures will be on the mild side. Right now we're at minus 8. The wind chill is minus 16.
The NDP is calling for part of the federal gasoline tax to be set aside for public transit. NDP leader Jack Layton says he'd like to see the proposal included in next month's federal budget. The NDP wants 1%, 1 cent per liter of the current federal tax on gas used for municipal spending on buses, trains and metros. Layton says that would mean an additional $400 to $500 million a year for Canadian municipalities. And astronauts from the space shuttle Endeavour completed a 6.5-hour spacewalk outside the International Space Station early this morning. They hitched the so-called Tranquility Room to the space station with the help of the Canadarm. The domed lookout has 7 windows, including the largest ever sent into space. Endeavour delivered the compartments earlier this week. Connecting. Well, the big day is finally here. The Vancouver 2010 Olympics officially open tonight, and Canada's hopes are high. On Talkback Montreal today, 69% say yes, Canada will surpass the 24 it won in Turin. 31% say no, it will not. And our thanks to everyone who took the time to vote in today's poll.
Plateau, fast, efficient language programs, foreign student visas, and unbeatable prices. Are you prepared to succeed? Learn a new language today at 281-1016.
August 5th, Bell Center. The event. Michael Bublé is coming home.
Let me go home.
In a spectacular new show. With special guest, Naturally 7. Tickets are on sale now by calling 790-2525 or order online at geg.ca. Michael Bublé, presented by Gillette Entertainment Group and Live Nation.
So what if it's getting cold and everyone's inside? My heart is warm as a fire when I'm by your side.
Walmart. Unbeatable prices on everything for Canadian families. Walmart. Save money, live better.
The secret to better hair color? It's Garnier Nutrice. The secret? With grapeseed and avocado oils, Nutrice starts nourishing while you color. Because nourished hair means better color. And Nutrice nourishes with both grapeseed and avocado oils for richer, more radiant color. Root to tip. And grays? They're your secret. Discover better color. It's Garnier Nutrice. Nourished hair, better color.
Garnier.
Take care.
Discover your shade at garnier.ca.
There was a lot of love going around at the Montreal Children's Hospital today. Children at the clinic's waiting area, just so glad to see our CTV mascot, Jellybean. They just covered him with hugs and kisses. He was there to deliver presents collected earlier by students and staff from 10 EMSB schools. It is an annual tradition on Valentine's Day. Over 7 years, these schools have also raised $57,000 for the Children's Cardiology Department and for brain tumor research.
Good for them. Mm-hmm. I feel out of place here. I have my red kind of tie on.
Randy didn't get the memo.
I forgot. I had my.
Clearly.
I forgot my I Believe t-shirt, sweatshirt. I was going to wear it and I forgot it.
And his wife is looking at it right now.
On the table.
Randy.
Yeah, it's right here on the table.
So how's it looking for the weekend?
Well, it's looking kind of cloudy here in Montreal, so definitely want to do something to put a smile on your Valentine's face this weekend. We may see a few snow showers around, a few flurries for Saturday, light snow showers for Sunday, no major accumulations, temperatures above normal. Guess we can't really complain here in Montreal. It's been
absolutely
an easy winter
not.
So far, knock on wood.
Needed a little balance here anyways, just a little bit. Enjoy the Olympics. We have no sports night. Enjoy the Olympics, everybody.
Have
go
a good weekend.
Go.
That's right.
Good night.
watching CTV News weekends at 11:30.